Okay, so on this one, this is about Ben Carson. It's known that he's a Seventh-day Adventist, and this is one of my concerns. You know, I know there's no religious test for the presidency, and some people would say, well, we'll never have an atheist president because atheists have such a bad reputation. And, you know, as far as I'm concerned, I'm kind of the other way, where it's like, okay, Seventh-day Adventists, what do they believe? Let's go to the website and see. And I'm wondering, is he too intellectually weak to be a leader of America? I mean, I want a smart guy to be a leader. And his let me just say what his church says, okay?
Go ahead.
It says in here, quote, Genesis tells us that a loving God split light from darkness and land from water, setting life in motion and sculpting the first human from clay. So he's basically saying he believes in a literal interpretation of Genesis where God scooped down, made humans out of clay and breathed life into it. And then also, let me read this here. It says, we owe our very breath to God, yet he gave us freedom to choose, a trait that risked catastrophe. A clever lie caused the first humans to question God's love and trustworthiness. Soon fear, envy, and indifference scarred the world. Separating us from God, sin warped all that was good. Hearts rebelled, bodies decayed, relationships rotted. And the thing I want to focus in is that it says bodies decayed. So he's one of these people that think there was no such thing as death until Adam sinned. And one thing I just want to point out is that even a lot of Christians are saying this, that, you know, when God created everything, he says it is good. And in order to be good, it has to be sustainable, which means you have to have death. Because if you didn't have death, you'd have so many creatures walking over each other, you wouldn't even have, you wouldn't be able to move anywhere if there was no death. So there had to be death at the very start of creation. Otherwise, it's not a good creation. It's not a good design.
So you have to understand, this is the young earth concept, and indeed the local flood and the global flood and the six literal day concept of creation actually is a 20th century kind of, it became big in the 20th century, and it was actually promoted by the Seventh-day Adventists, so it's not surprising the Seventh-day Adventists do that. Now, given all that, we have to take a step back and say, look, this guy is definitely knows more about biology than you or me, right?
Oh, I don't know about that.
Well, he knows enough about biology to do surgery on people.
You don't need to know biology to do brain surgery, though.
Oh, of course you do. You have to understand how the body works.
No, you have to know how to cut and how to repair and things like that.
No,
medical doctors don't.
You don't try to get through med school without knowing biology? I mean, come on.
No. Medical doctors, there's a huge difference between understanding of biology with a PhD who's a biologist to a medical doctor. A medical doctor, it's like a bachelor's level of biology.
I didn't say he knows more biology than a PhD in biology. I said he knows more biology than you and me.
I don't know about that. how smart can he be if he thinks the world is 6,000 years old or the universe is 6,000 years old? That's my whole problem with this.
I think he can be very smart.
What can he know about biology when he thinks humans were made from clay? Come on.
Well, okay. For the clay thing because basically the concept of clay is it's symbolic of being made from earth.
It's not symbolic for him though.
We'd have
it's
to
literal.
I don't want to put words in his mouth. But yeah, maybe he does think it's literal. But again, remember this. If you believe in a God who suspends the law of nature for his creation, right, and then creates things. So look, as I said, I'm an old earth creationist. But if somebody could come tomorrow and say, look, this is actually how it happened, do I think God could do it in 6 days? Absolutely. I just don't think the evidence is there that he did it that way.
Well, and this guy, if he also thinks that the earth and the sun and the whole universe is only like 6,000 years old, I'm thinking, look, this is not even passing basic level of scientific knowledge. This is scary for me to get some guy like this as the president.
Yeah, again, I mean,
if he's not smart enough to know that, it's scary what he would think.
But I think you can go back and Thomas Jefferson thought the earth was made in 6 days. I mean, you can go back to a whole bunch of these guys.
I want to go to modern times. I want to go to modern times, though.
Yeah, but so I don't think
we have the internet now and Google.
So all you're saying is that you disagree with the foundational principles of how the earth was created with him. But that doesn't mean he's unintelligent.
Well,
it
I mean, a
sixth
grader would disagree with this. I mean, anybody with a basic scientific education would know that it's ridiculous that to think the universe is 6,000 years old.
But no, but the minute you allow for the supernatural agent who is outside of time and space to start manipulating things, then you allow for a lot of these things.
The moment you allow magical thinking to come in, God can do things by magic. Everything's possible.
No, I don't think it's magic. I think it's supernatural. I think there's a difference between magic and supernatural.
No, that's the definition of magic, actually.
Magic is where it's illogical and has no definition.
No, magic is doing... I've looked at this definition multiple times. Part of magic is defined by doing works that are supernatural. It says mysterious or supernatural. Okay. That's a dictionary definition.
No. So supernatural would be... So again, going back to the whole time and space thing, at the foundation of the Big Bang, there were about 10 dimensions. So a three-dimensional creature, if a five-dimensional creature were to do something to a three-dimensional creature, like step into a room for a three-dimensional creature, it would look like magic. He's not violating any laws of nature. He's just doing something that is supernatural, takes some other dimensional thing.
Okay.
For an example, a two-dimensional creature, to the two-dimensional creature, a wall is a line.
Mm-hmm.
A room would be four lines, and you'd need a door to come in and out. But I, as a three-dimensional creature, could step into that room without the door being open. So supernatural can be explained in logical terms, in multidimensional terms. And when you start moving to extra-dimensional, if God is capable of creating space, matter, energy, and time, then surely he's able to interact in time and space in different ways. So I don't think it's magical. The question is, did he leave any clues that he did it that way? I don't think he did. I think he's quite capable of doing it. I don't necessarily think that he did it that way. That's all.
Okay, let's leave it there and go on to the next topic.
Good.
Okay, so the next one is Bernie Sanders.